Recently, most companies and organizations used centralized system for their data processing needs, but as technology improved and data processing became more complex and load on the centralized system increased and a new way of data processing evolved, distributed data processing, DDP, or distributed processing in short, remote terminals. In a centralized data processing system, the CPU, the storage device, software, and the professional data processing staff are located in one central facility. All the devices in the centralized system, including multiplexers, terminals, and printers, coverage on one central computer, even though the users may work at distant terminals. All processing and storage take place in central location, but the distributed data processing system, the computers, storage devices, and even some computer professionals are distributed, so separate locations throughout the organization. Processing and storage may occur at several locations in the computer system called a network. Several computers, each located at the different points or nodes in the network, may be used in advances in communication technology have made possible the integration of those computers located at different places. Most organizations can be benefit from using distributed processing. Such a system can be more responsive to its users' needs, and it may cost less to develop the maintain than the centralized system. Distributing the processing and storage function. Although sharing the processing function distributes the computing load to computers away from the central computer, in the most cases, distributed data processing is chosen because storage too can be distributed. Furthermore, and data stored at different locations can be shared among the users. The following examples show how these characteristics of the distributed system can help an organization use its data resources more effectively. It shows how the distributed processing system used in multi-branch banking are effective are different than the centralized system. In the distributed multi-branch banking system, many computers are used at the branch banks and are responsible for the local processing of services. Such as saving and current accounts and loans, each machine uses a copy of the same software for those functions. A mainframe at the central facility performs all of the consolidated accounting functions and is responsible for processing both the transactions through the bank's networks of animated teller machines or automated teller machines or ATMs and credit cards transactions. Now let us consider how the ATM application works. When a customer initiates a withdrawal transaction, the data associated with the request are first sent to the central computer. The branch at which the consumer record and maintained must be determined and the request forwarded to the appropriate branch computer. The branch computer performs a search to verify the consumer's account and determines whether the balance in the account is adequate. If there is enough money in the account, the depositor's record will be updated to reflect the withdrawal. Next, the data are returned to the ATM and the machine dispense the cash and prints a receipt. All these events take place with the span of few seconds. Most distributed system are very complex. For example, in the above case, the branch computers must perform as stand-alone machines while simultaneously increasing with other machines in the network and share data as well. Advantages of distributed systems. The advantage of distributed processing including local control of local data. The major benefit from distributed data processing system is local control of local data. This means that the local organization can take more responsibility for developing, scheduling, introducing and managing applications. Above all, a local perspective can keep the information system more focused on the local organization objectives. Lower cost. Often the hardware is a distributed system is less expensive than that for a centralized system. Several mini computer or mini computers cost less than one mainframe. The maintenance cost of those machines are also less compared to the centralized system machines. Modularity. Distributed systems tend to be modular as the demand for processing increase. Most micros, minis and other supportive equipments such as secondary storage device and pin printers can be added to the network, for example in a local network. When a new microcomputer needs to be added, is simply plugged to the system and within minutes it's a functioning part of the existing network. Better response time. When only one centralized computer is used, the response time to a user's request can be delayed or as more users make demands on the system. But in distributed system, local processing is done on local machines, and in many systems, local machines only occasionally need to call upon the resources of the other machines in the system. As a result, there will not be much increase in the response system as more users are added to a distributed system. Ability to share data. Another advantage of distributed system is its ability to share data across the nodes in a network. Without a network, it is difficult or impossible to share data. Of course, the floppy disk from one machine can be taken to another and the data can be shared this way, but it is much more convenient if the machines can share data through the electronic interface of a network. Greater reliability. Still another advantage of distributed system is the reliability. If the centralized system breaks down, the whole operation of the organization will to be to a halt. Networks in general are not subject to such catastrophes. If one computer in the network breaks down, the rest of the machines may not be affected, depending on the network's topology. Direct user interaction. Another advantage is that users directly interact with the information system is distributed processing. This means that users will not consider the computer an unapproachable, mysterious black box located behind closed doors. Disadvantages of distributed systems. Distributed networks have disadvantages too, and those must be considered before a system is decentralized. They include technical problems of connecting dissimilar machines. Technical problems can sometimes be overwhelming for a distributed system. Additional layers of operating system software are needed to translate and cooperate the flow of data between machines. Sometimes a link between machine frames and microcomputers can be difficult to establish. Need for sophisticated communication system. Distributed processing require the development of a data communication system. This system can be closely to develop and use. In addition, their maintenance can be a costly affair. Data integrity and security problems. Because data maintained by distributed system can be accessed by at many locations in the network, controlling the integrity of a database can be difficult. lack of professional support. Finally, distributed computers are often placed in locations where little or no data processing support is available, and consequently there will be a run by non-professionals. Another aspect is that the communication system also require highly trained personnel for their maintenance. The internet is a global system of interconnected computer networks that interchanges data by package switching using this standardized internet protocol suite. And TCP/IP, it is a network of networks that consists of millions of private and public, academic, business and government networks of local to global scope that are linked by copper wires, fiber optics, cables, wireless connections and other technologies. The internet carries various information resources.